After a partial bridge collapse at the Andheri suburban station in Mumbai, a public transport bus today met with an accident in the state. The accident saw the double-decker bus's roof get ripped off after it crashed into an overhead barricade. The Trump administration failed to meet its deadline to issue a notification with regard to its authorization of H-4 visa users. These users are spouses of H-1B visa holders. This is the second time this year the administration has failed to meet the deadline. Flight operations started today between Nepalganj and Similot to bring back the stranded Indian pilgrims who had taken the Nepal route for the Kailash Mansarovar Yatra. The operations would be a gradual process and much depends on the weather conditions. The Supreme Court today declined urgent listing of BJP leader Subramanian Swamy's plea. Swamy was seeking enforcement of his fundamental right to worship at the disputed Ram temple at Ayodhya. Instead, the court has asked him to mention it again later on. Rajkumar Hirani's Sanju is busy soaring at the box office. The film is already racing towards the Rs 150 crore mark and raked in Rs 25.35 crore on day 4, taking its total collection so far to Rs 145.41 crore. Speaking on his fantastic depiction of Sanjay Dutt's drug addiction in Sanju, Ranbir Kapoor has revealed that he too had experimented with drugs in college. He went on to add that Sanju is a lesson for youngsters. He said, 5 minutes of ecstasy can destroy your entire life. The Supreme Court today reserved its verdict on pleas seeking direction to curb cow vigilantism. The apex court said this was a law and order issue and each state has to be responsible. The court said it will pass an order on the pleas. Three pilgrims died today en route to the holy cave shrine of Amarnath due to various causes. With these, the death toll in this year's Yatra has gone up to 6, including 3 pilgrims, 1 BSF officer, 1 palanquin carrier and 1 Yatra volunteer. The Supreme Court today restricted the choice of state governments in appointment of Director General of Police to ensure unwarranted influence or pressure on the police. The court said state governments should send their proposal to the UPSC 3 months before the incumbent is due to retire. The court was hearing a petition filed by a former IPS officer for reforms and transparency in the functioning of state police forces. A local firm has launched an official website on UAE-Iceberg project to highlight the upcoming stages. The National Advisor Bureau put forward the project of towing icebergs from Antarctica to the UAE coast during the first quarter of 2020. This is to leverage new sources of water in the region.